Good evening, YouTube. Well, our last video was building the new light grow light shelf, and I said I was hoping to get the money to replace everything with the LED lighting. Well, that hasn't happened yet, but I got a fantastic deal on Kijiji. I found someone who had rewired their barn and put in the high efficiency lights and had taken out the T8 ballast. So they sold me three ballasts at $5 a piece. Those are worth around $48 each new. And I found someone else, this is one I already had, but who had a box of the F32 T8 daylight bulbs, which are, 6,100 Kelvin? 6,500 Kelvin. And 10 tubes, I need 12 for this. I have one left over. So I'm gonna get two of these switched over right away. And I thought I'd take you along for the ride for how to do it for the first one. So you can see here, can you see here? All four tubes are lit.
I can see three. Because one is too high. Like, I have to go down to here.
That's why I brought the other camera, too.
Can we go down?
Only if you unlock the...
Ah. Yeah. Here we go. Four tubes.
Okay, so these fixtures have a ballast for every pair of tubes. These ballasts are one ballast for every four tubes. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to turn that off and take out the bulbs. Now, depending on the age of your fixture, there may not be a center cover. If they were meant to have a complete lens in front of them all the time, although most of them do have a center cover anyway. Now, also depending on the age, the older ones had as many as three screws on each side of the cover holding them in place. And the new ones, can you get the camera right in here, babe? I don't know if it's going to be enough light for you to see this. Have little tabs sticking down out of the top.
Take the light away. Ah, now I can see it.
Ah. A little tab sticking down out of the top that these just pop in and out of. It may seem sort of senseless to pull the wires straight and then put the caps on. But you never know when you're going to get called away from a job. And I wouldn't want to have to go out and come back and find that somebody had turned the switch on and then touched the wires. So the first thing we did is unhook the power.
There's the first ballast out.
These are held in with a pair of perforations that are pressed down to form a hanger on this side. So we are going to put one from the other side in. Tape it in place so it can't fall out while we're trying to mount this. So, we need a blue and a red to go to this side. Black and a yellow to go to this side. Or black and a white to go to this side, rather. A yellow to go to this side. A blue and a yellow to go to this side. Blue and a red to go to this side. A blue and a red to go to this side. A yellow to go to this side. Then a mar clip, a wire nut.
Plastic doohickey?
To isolate and insulate. And really, the rest of the wiring is just the same color code, blue to blue, red to red, yellow to yellow, blue to blue, red to red, black and white to the power coming in. So we will come back and show you when that's all done. And we're back. Now, I should mention, you notice that the wires are all twisted a little bit on the outside of the wire nut. That's how you know when the wire nuts are on tight enough. You twist the bare wire together, you put the wire nut on and twist it, and when you're able to put more or less a full turn and a half in the wire beyond, that's when your wire nut is tight enough. So, because you can't, if you hold the wire tight right where the wire nut couples and keep twisting the wire nut, you will snap the wires off. When you're putting fluorescent tubes in, you want to try and hold it so that the pins are straight up and down. Push them right into the top, and then a half turn and you can feel it lock. And then
there be light?
Yeah, sometimes new bulbs will take a couple of minutes to come on completely, just because the powder coating on the inside of the bulb isn't distributed as evenly as possible, because they've been standing up on end too long. But that will take care of itself. So there you go. How about we do this so
that yep.
you can get the camera so you're not looking up at my nose hairs?
Yeah, it may help.
That is how to convert either a T12 or a T10 light fixture to a T8. The T12s, the T10s, and the T8s all use the same end clip, so changing the ballast is all that's required. Did you get that in the shot? That's it for now, and thanks for watching. With my